Hello and welcome back. In this video, I want to show you how you can use the Edit Product Form widget to allow your users to edit the products on the front end. So for example, if I come here to my car listings, you can see that some of these cars are mine. It says dealer Shabtai, and some of these belong to someone named James. Now next to mine, I can see a little edit icon, and if I press this, I'm given a form. This is an Elementor off-canvas widget with a front-end admin edit product form widget. I'm going to edit some of these details and click submit. My car has been updated. Now let's log in as James. For the sake of this video, I opened up a incognito window already and I logged in as James. As you can see here, when I'm logged in as James, I have a little edit icon next to James's car listings. And if I come in here, let's just change this car a little bit. I can see my changes are being reflected on the front end. So how do we set this up that each author will be able to edit their own products from the front end? So let's go ahead and log into Elementor. As you can see here, my car listings, and I have my grid loop widget. Let's go ahead and edit this template. The first thing we're going to want to do is bring in a button. This button is what's going to open up the edit canvas widget. Just go ahead and drag that right over the image. Let's choose an icon from the icon library. Let's look for the pencil icon and insert that. Next, let's get rid of this text. Go into the advanced tab and change the position to absolute. Now it's at the top left. We're going to want to change it to be at the top right. Adjust the offset a little bit. Just set the offset to 10. Now let's take away all the padding. We're going to have to go into the style tab and change the padding to 0. Next, make the background transparent. So great, so now we have this pencil icon and it's white on white. So just change the text color to black. So now we have a little button here. And this is going to be a little bit annoying because when we hover over this, we got the Elementor pencil icon. So let's go ahead and adjust the offset a bit more to be a bit lower. Okay, moves it to the left a little bit. And let's go ahead and just adjust the offset to 30. And so now it's not conflicting with the Elementor icon. And so now we have our button. So now let's add the off-canvas widget with the edit product form. Off canvas, let's go ahead and drag that wherever, it doesn't matter. And let's look for the edit product widget. Edit product form widget. Just drag that right into the off canvas widget. And there we have it. There's nothing else that we need to do, except if you want to add some more fields. So I'm actually going to go ahead and add a category field. Product information. Categories. Let's go ahead and add a tags field as well. And let's add a sale price field. Drag that right under the price field. And now let's go ahead and add another button as a cancel button. So take this button, drag it right under the form. Let's make it red. The background color red. Let's center it and change the text to cancel. And now click on dynamic tags and choose off canvas. And you're going to want to choose this widget, the off canvas widget. And let's choose close off canvas. Now let's go ahead and close this off canvas and edit this button to open up that off canvas widget with the form. So go ahead and click on the button widget, click on dynamic tags, scroll down to off canvas and choose our off canvas widget. And let's choose open off canvas. And so now when this button is clicked, our little form is going to open up. All right, so that's it. Now we want to make sure that only the author of this product, who's the dealer, only they should see this button and the off-canvas widget. So Elementor actually has conditions, but we're not going to use those because this option doesn't exist there. We need something very dynamic. We need to compare the current post author or the current product author with the current user ID. And that's not possible with these display conditions. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to close this and open up the content tab. We have conditions here. Let's add a or group. So the way these conditions work is it works similar, except you have or condition groups in which you can add any number of and conditions. And so if any of these rules apply, this group is true. And then you can add another group. And here it's an or group. So if one of these groups is true, then the widget will show. So let's go ahead and remove all of these, and let's remove this or group because we only need one condition rule. That one condition rule is post author equals current user. Go ahead and save conditions. And now this button will only show for the product's author. Let's go ahead and do the same thing for the off-canvas widget. Scroll down to front-end admin conditions. Manage conditions, add an or group, and add the same rule. Post author equals current user. Save conditions. Now let's go ahead and publish. Now let's take a look at the page, see what we've done. Perfect. Let's click on the icon, see if it opens up the form. Great. And we see it's dynamic, so each icon is opening up only that product. I don't have the option to edit this product, but if I log in as James, I see that I do have this option. And so that's it. That's how you can add a edit product form widget to your product list very easily using Frontend Admin and Elementor Pro. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this content, please give us a like, subscribe to our channel, and give us a 5-star review on WordPress.org.